engage enemy ground forces.
Hey, 1-1, flying two away.
Better weather tomorrow.
Well, they probably did it above the clouds. We just didn't know it.
That's true. That's true. That could be no problem if we were doing this up high for real. It's beautiful above today.
You know, I made a remark earlier about how the system.
Ladies and gentlemen, next up we have a parachute demonstration brought to you by the Elite Warriors of U.S. Army Special Operations Command Black Dagger Parachute Demonstration Team. The U.S. Army Special Operations Command was activated December 1st, 1989 at the home of Airborne, Fort Bragg, North Carolina, and is the Army component of the U.S. Special Operations Command. The Army Special Operations Command mission is to deploy highly trained and equipped Army Special Operations forces worldwide to conduct special operations in support of geographic combatant commanders, American ambassadors, and other agencies. The U.S. Army Special Operations Command, or USASOC, is in charge of all Army active duty special operations forces and is comprised of four subordinate commands. The 1st Special Forces Command, the 75th Ranger Regiment, the Army Special Operations Aviation Regiment, and the John F. Kennedy Special Warfare Center and School.
Right now is what is called a streamer drop. Those are wind drift indicators. Pieces of crepe paper about 10 inches wide, about 15 feet long. And wrapped up in the bottom is about a quarter inch dowel rod of wood that gives it a little weight. And that gives the team leader from the Black Daggers the opportunity to see what the winds are doing. Master Sergeant Travis Alfred, Sergeant First Class Aaron Fiegel, Master Sergeant Chris Malone, Staff Sergeant Sean O'Toole, Staff Sergeant Kurt Loader, Sergeant First Class Chance Carrico, Sergeant First Class Wes Cato, Staff Sergeant Steve Travers, Staff Sergeant Chris Hardy, Sergeant First Class John Franey, and Sergeant First Class John Morales. All members of the Black Daggers parachute team are doing something they just don't like to do, and that's land in an airplane. They would much rather land under their own canopies when they're in control to do a tiptoe landing rather than land in a plane, but unable to do the jump because these clouds are just too low to make it safe.
From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from the sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to L.A. Well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and stand.
Taxi by to wave thanks for allowing us the great privilege of presenting to you this year's Fleet Air Power demonstration.
You got it. Thank you.
But Eric, no flare, they're going to touch down, but they're going to modify the rollout, I think, aren't they?
Well, obviously, when we're not on a carrier deck, we got to worry about stopping. So if we're going to take off, if we're on landing on a carrier deck, we're going to throw those throttles up to military power as soon as we touch down. Conversely, at the field, obviously, idle speed breaks out, and maybe even raise that nose to help us get slowed down. 8,000 feet, actually, is not the easiest to slow down with a 44,000 pounds of going.
About a minute apart. Is that the way it works on the deck of the carrier as well?
Well, we're targeting somewhere around a minute on an aircraft carrier. We got to have time to trap and get out of the way so the next aircraft can safely land. Gentlemen, in just a moment, Commander McAllister will lead this year's Fleet Airpower demonstration for a show line taxi to wave thanks for your support. As they taxi by, I invite you to wave back to Lieutenant Bill Kowski, Lieutenant Commander Sheets, Lieutenant Malaki, Lieutenant Coker, and Lieutenant Carrasquillo and Lieutenant Galicio. Strike Fighter Wing Atlantic and Captain Richard Meadows, Commanding Officer of Naval Air Station Oceana, we thank you for the privilege of presenting to you the 2017 Fleet Air Power Demonstration. Fly Navy.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up if you will for your United States Navy Fleet Power Demonstration. Yes, indeed. We are so grateful for their demonstration, and we're very, very sorry that they were unable, if you will, to pull that off today, to bring in a POWMIA flag. And they were unable to jump it today, but I would like to remind you that Friday, September 18th, is National Prisoner of War Missing in Action Recognition Day. And that flag that we had hoped to see in the sky as a symbol of those brave Americans that were held captive or listed as missing in action. Every single day, each one of us is cognizant of the service and sacrifice of our POWs and those missing in action. Some of us more than others, but this is the day designated for all of us to gather and openly remember and pay tribute to.